researchers found potential drugs as early treatment of COVID-19 via genetics. A team of researchers has identified potential drugs as early treatment for COVID-19. Their study suggests that these medications should be prioritized in clinical trials, which target two proteins linked to COVID-19 disease progression. Detailed in Nature Medicine, Dr. Juan P. Casas, a physician epidemiologist at the Veterans Affairs Boston Healthcare System, led the team in using genetics. Genetics have been their starting point because over 90% of drugs target one human protein encoded by a gene. If a protein associated with SARS-CoV-2 infection could be targeted, it would hinder the virus's ability to infect cells normally. This would slow down the infection, give time for the immune system to fight back, and decrease the severity of symptoms. He cited one example, a gene that encodes the PCSK9 protein, which is targeted by drugs called PCSK9 inhibitors. When targeted, the inhibitors would lower cholesterol levels and reduce the risk of cardiovascular diseases. In people, many possess a specific variant of this gene that usually raises their cholesterol levels and risk of CVD. According to Medical Express, the team identified all genes that encode proteins, which served as targets for FDA-approved medications or drugs in clinical development. A set of 1,263 genes has been called actionable druggable genome and was derived from over 7,500 hospitalized COVID-19 patients and a million COVID-free controls. They found that drugs targeting ACE2 and IFNAR2 proteins have the potential to hinder COVID-19 progression. ACE2 is a must for SARS-CoV-2 to infect human cells, and anything that manipulates it also manipulates the virus in a sense. The drug APN01 shows the best promise in treating COVID-19 as it replicates the protein. The coronavirus can get confused by attaching to the drug instead of the true ACE2. A small trial revealed that those hospitalized due to COVID-19 and then treated with APN01 gained significant benefits. IFNAR2 protein, meanwhile, is a possible target for drugs called type 1 interferons. These are approved for treating patients with a degenerative form of multiple sclerosis. In COVID-19, researchers discovered that people with a variant of IFNAR2 are less likely to get hospitalized than those without. With these findings, the team is planning a trial to test the safety and efficacy of interferon beta in COVID-19 outpatients. Success in that trial will confirm the genetic-based results. It will also indicate that a drug must be prescribed to those who are diagnosed with COVID-19 to prevent the risk of hospitalization.